Hey everyone, so here's a leg day workout, and as you can see from the title, I obviously worked on some overhead squats. I haven't done these in a while, and I forgot exactly how hard they are. It's not the squatting portion that's hard, it's just the, once you add stabilizing the bar over your head, it's pretty difficult, so it's something that you don't want to just go throwing a whole bunch of weight on the bar. You definitely want to focus on form, because you can easily injure yourself with just throwing a whole bunch of weight on these. So I started off with just the bar just to kind of get a feel for it. I started off with 15 reps for a warm-up, just kind of focusing on my form and what I was doing. And then I decided to go ahead and add some weight on there, and then that's when I realized I need to kind of take things down a notch and really just focus on just using the bar and focusing on form. Because for one thing, it was interesting trying to get the bar up there. Normally, you could just do a snatch, but if, like right there, if you don't really have your snatch down correctly and aren't really prepared for that weight, then it's not going to go up. So I haven't snatched in a while, so that was interesting. And yeah, here I am trying just a little bit of weight. And as soon as I went down for that first rep, I realized, yeah, those were going to be a lot harder than I thought. Not that I'm afraid of doing something hard. It's just that with these, I wanted to make sure that I really focus on form over trying to throw weight on the bar, since I haven't done these in a while, and you could easily hurt yourself. I also want to say that these are a really great exercise if you're short on time, because they do work a lot of different muscle groups. They're going to work your lower body, your upper body, your core. You've got to stabilize that bar. So these are a great exercise to throw in there if you're short on time.
We'll be right back.
And then just to get a really good pump in my legs, I decided to follow up the overheads with some front squats. These felt a lot more difficult than I was expecting, since I didn't really have much weight on the overhead squats. When I was doing them, I wasn't really feeling a pump in my legs, but once I threw some weight on for the front squats, I definitely felt, I could feel the after effects of the overhead squats. But yeah, I finished up with, I did four sets of the front squats. I'm only showing two sets on here. Alright, and here are some reverse lunges off of a platform. And so these are going to take the emphasis off of your quads and put it more so on your glutes. And these can be a little tricky to do if your balance is a little off, so you definitely want to take your time doing these. I don't know if I caught it in this clip, but there were one or two times when I had to catch my balance. So what I was doing was... There you go. Falling a little bit. So what I was doing was looking at, watching myself in the mirror and looking at a certain spot on the ground behind me, and then just always trying to make sure that I hit that spot so that way I wasn't lunging too far backward, and it also just helped me to keep my balance. And so as far as the platform, you can build a platform with stacks of plates as well if you don't have these platforms at your gym. You could just grab like two 45 pound plates, three 45 pound plates, and do them that way. So yeah, these are really great motion. Focus more on the glutes than the quads. Of course, you're still going to work quads, but you're just not going to feel it there quite as much. And then I finished up with some calf raises, and like I normally do when I do my standing calf raises, I change my foot position. So in this clip, I have my toes pointed outward. And what I do is I actually do them with my toes pointed forward, then outward, then inward, and then I do single leg calf raises. Just always want to hit the calves from different angles so that you can definitely get that pop in your calves. And like I always say, don't forget your calves. That's one big thing that people tend to forget when they work out their legs. I don't know why. I love having awesome calves, so I'm definitely going to work them out whenever I do legs. And here are some if I could talk today, that would be great. So here are some deficit squats, and all I'm doing is using the platform for assisted pull-ups. And to make it a little bit easier to grab that dumbbell, I had one dumbbell underneath it to lift it up. The idea is that you can take the dumbbell just a little bit further past ground level, and so that's just going to give you a much bigger range of motion than if you were just standing flat on the ground and doing your squats that way with the dumbbell. Alright, so I finished off legs and glutes with four sets of leg presses, and all I did for each one was start off with a wide stance, hit 15 reps, and then I brought my feet in for a narrow stance for 10 reps, and I was definitely feeling the burn on those. It's not a whole lot of weight on there, but with that many reps, definitely going to feel the burn. It's just putting emphasis on different parts of your legs, moving your foot position. And then I finished off with some calf presses on the leg press machine as well. And so that was my whole workout. So thanks for watching, guys. Appreciate the support. Appreciate the views and the comments. And as always, you can check me out on Instagram @liftheavykickass. And until next time, guys. Thanks.